is the Prop Doctor, and it's been a while. 3 months to be exact since my last actual video. I'm sorry guys that I haven't been posting much. I know a lot has happened. Trans World, all the Morris leaks, Home Depot leaks, which this video is about, and all sorts of other stuff. I have been very busy with school and other things in my life, but I am back to posting, hopefully. I want to pump out videos about upcoming things and current things and my thoughts on the lineup so far. A while ago, I was going to have a Hanging Hell Fiend unboxing because I finally got a hold of one, but it didn't work as I thought it did in the post, so I had to send it back, and I didn't get to make a video about it, which was very unfortunate because, as some of you may know, he is one of my favorite spirit props, and I was so happy to have him. But, I wanted to take this minute to address why I've been gone, and to plug my Twitch, which is on the screen right now. I have been streaming on Twitch recently, and I would really appreciate it if you guys could go follow my Twitch. And I also see that we are extremely close to 800 subscribers. Three away, actually. So if you guys could subscribe, that would mean the world to me. I'd love to hit 1,000 subscribers by the end of this year. But enough of me talking. You guys came to see Home Depot leaks. So let me show you these Home Depot leaks. On screen right now are a couple of the pictures of Home Depot leaks. I will be going into depth about them with my thoughts and seeing if I can find anything else in the background of these pictures. So let's get into our first picture. Alright, our first image here is the new Headless Horseman. I believe it was 9 feet tall. It is a static. I'm pretty sure it's a static. But as you can see, it has the poseable skeleton head from last year. And the horse just looks absolutely awesome. This thing is dope. I really like the coat on it with the boots. And the fact that it's pretty big, too, makes it even cooler. I really love the overall design of the horse. That's the main piece, in my opinion. And the only thing, the weight needs to be evenly distributed, or it needs to have the greatest supports known to man, because that thing is just leaning back. But that's really all I have to say about this first picture. Alright, so now what I'm most excited for, and I'm sure most of you are too, is the 12-foot Servo Reaper. This thing is awesome. I believe it is Servo. I'm not 100% sure, but just look at this thing. It's very much resembling of the witch from a couple of years ago, the 12-foot witch, how she holds her broom. But he is a scythe, and he just looks awesome, dude. I cannot wait for this thing. I can't wait to see this thing in person. There also is what looks to be a fog tube down there. I'm not sure if you guys can see that. I might just be a big plug, but it kind of looks like a fog tube to me. It'd be awesome if he could fog like Grim Death from Distortions. That'd be awesome. But I am extremely excited to see what this thing has in store for us. Next, we have the Gangster Skeleton, I don't know his official name, and the Murderous Maple. I like the Gangster Skeleton's design, but I'm not the biggest fan of him personally. I really like the cigar and the glass he holds, but that's really all I really like about him. However, the Murderous Maple, I really like it. It's 10 feet tall. It looks pretty awesome. And that'd be really cool for, like, a graveyard or a farm. I think that would even work in a farm. That'd look pretty cool. And if it's sturdy enough, being able to attach, like, one of those spirit swinging mechanisms on like, the ghost swing or something, or just a normal swing, would be awesome. just think of it like you got this empty swing on an evil tree. That's pretty dope right there. Here we have the Plague Doctor and the Pirate. Not the biggest fan of the Pirate. He looks pretty cool. I'll have to see him in person before I get a final opinion on him. But this Plague Doctor, I am definitely excited for. We don't see too many Plague Doctors, surprisingly. And this guy looks awesome. In this image, his eyes are blue, but in the video I've seen, they're purple. I don't know why they're blue here, but he just looks awesome. His cane looks cool. His outfit looks amazing. The lantern's a nice touch. And he just looks awesome. And then on the Pirate, he has the typical pirate sword. Not too much going on with his outfit. I like the Parrot. His face looks pretty realistic. He also is Servo, I believe. And as someone pointed out, I forget who, he has the same stance as Straw Man, which is pretty interesting. But I'm very excited to see what these two have in store for us. And let's move on to our next pictures. Alright, in these last three images, you can see three more of the new animatronics. We have the dog for the 12-foot skeleton. Pretty cool. An accessory for all those people who have 12-foot skeletons. Then we have the witch. It's a witch. We have a new cauldron, it looks like. That's pretty cool. And besides the cauldron, you can see the 3-foot Inferno pumpkin. And underneath the dog, you can also see a new, like a crow on a cross. And you can see the Gravedigger is returning, and the Plague Doctor is behind the dog along with the Headless Horseman. And then in the picture on the left, you can see a Home Depot poster behind the skeleton's arm along with a Nosferatu, which he looks pretty cool, I'm not going to lie. In this lighting, he looks awesome. But, I don't think I'm forgetting anything. Oh yeah, and then there's this thing, which is supposedly is the Sitter of Souls, Sister of Souls, Sitter, Sister, whatever it is, that thing, this is its brother, so I don't really care if it has any correlation to that. If it does, then I hate it, and I'm not gonna talk about it. So, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I will see you in the next one. See ya. Spooky, scary skeletons and shivers.